This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Lawrence Mark Larry sæŋər, born July 16, 1968, is an American internet project developer, co-founder of Wikipedia, and the founder of Citizendium. He grew up in Anchorage, Alaska. From an early age, he has been interested in philosophy. Sæŋər received a Bachelor of Arts in Philosophy from Reed College in 1991 and a Doctor of Philosophy in Philosophy from Ohio State University in 2000. Most of his philosophical work has focused on epistemology, the theory of knowledge. He has been involved with various online encyclopedia projects. He is the former editor-in-chief of Nupedia, chief organizer 2001-02 of its successor, Wikipedia, and founding editor-in-chief of Citizendium. From his position at Nupedia, he assembled the process for article development. Sæŋər proposed implementing a wiki, which led directly to the creation of Wikipedia. Initially, Wikipedia was a complementary project for Nupedia. He was Wikipedia's early community leader and established many of its original policies. Sæŋər left Wikipedia in 2002, and has since been critical of the project. He states that, despite its merits, Wikipedia lacks credibility due to, among other things, a lack of respect for expertise. In October 2006, Sæŋər started a somewhat similar encyclopedia to Wikipedia, Citizendium. Sæŋər has taught philosophy at Ohio State University and was an early strategist for the expert-authored Encyclopedia of Earth. He has worked on developing educational projects for individuals behind WatchNoLearn. He has designed a web-based reading program named Reading Bear, which aims to teach children how to read. In February 2013, he attempted to start a news crowdsourcing project named Infobit. It ran out of money in mid-2015 without the code being ready to handle a full-scale launch. Contents 1. Early life and education. 2. Philosophy. 3. Nupedia and Wikipedia. 31. Origins of Wikipedia. 4. Post-Wikipedia. 5. Citizendium. 6. Post-Citizendium. 7. Personal life. 8. Selected writings. 9. References. 10. External links. Early life and education. Sæŋər was born in Bellevue, Washington. His father was a marine biologist and his mother cared for the children when he was 7 years old. The family moved to Anchorage, Alaska at an early age. He was interested in philosophical topics. He graduated from high school in 1986 and went off to Reed College, majoring in philosophy. In college, he became interested in the internet and its publishing abilities. He set up a list server as a medium for students and tutors to meet up for expert tutoring and to act as a forum for discussion of tutorials, tutorial methods, and the possibility and merits of a voluntary, free network of individual tutors and students finding each other via the internet for education outside the traditional university setting. He started and moderated a philosophy discussion list, the Association for Systematic Philosophy. Sæŋər wrote in 1994 a manifesto for the discussion group. The history of philosophy is full of disagreement and confusion. One reaction by philosophers to this state of things is to doubt whether the truth about philosophy can ever be known, or whether there is any such thing as the truth about philosophy. But there is another reaction: one may set out to think more carefully and methodically than one's intellectual forebears. Sæŋər received a Bachelor of Arts degree in philosophy from Reed College in 1991, a Master of Arts from Ohio State University in 1995, and a Doctor of Philosophy from Ohio State University in 2000. Beginning in 1998, he ran a website called Sæŋər's Review of Y2K News Reports, a resource for those concerned about the year 2000 problem, such as managers of computer systems. Philosophy. In 2007, Sæŋər examined the possibilities for education online. He explained, "Imagine that education were not delivered but organized and managed in a way that were fully digitized, decentralized, self-directed, asynchronous, and at a distance." He further stated, "There would be no bureaucracy to enforce anything beyond some very basic rules, and decision-making would be placed almost entirely in the hands of teachers and students." In 2007, Sæŋər wrote an essay for The Edge stating in part, "As it turns out, our many Web 20 revolutionaries have been so thoroughly seized with the successes of strong collaboration that they are resistant to recognizing some hard truths. As wonderful as it might be that the hegemony of professionals over knowledge is lessening, there is a downside. Our grasp of and respect for reliable information suffers with the rejection of professionalism. Has come a widespread rejection of expertise, of the proper role in society of people who make it their life's work to to know stuff. This, I maintain, is not a positive development, but it is also not a necessary one. We can imagine a Web 20 with experts. We can imagine an internet that is still egalitarian, but which is more open and welcoming to specialists. The new politics of knowledge that I advocate would place experts at the head of the table, but, unlike the old order, gives the general public a place at the table as well. In 2008, sæŋər was at Oxford University to debate the proposition that the internet is the future of knowledge. Sæŋər agreed that today's wikis and blogs are fundamentally changing the way knowledge is created and distributed. In 2010, sæŋər wrote an article for Educause stating in part, "In the last several years, many observers of education and learning have been stunned by the abundance of information online, the ever-faster findability of answers, and the productivity of online crowds, which have created information resources like Wikipedia and YouTube. The enormous scope of these developments has surprised me too, despite the fact that they are more or less what many of us had hoped for and deliberately tried to bring into being. These sudden, revolutionary developments demand analysis. How is this latest information explosion changing the way we live? Is the relationship between society and individual changing? More to the point for this article, how is the internet revolution changing education, Nupedia and Wikipedia? Further information, history of Wikipedia. The Bomis staff in the summer of 2000. Sæŋər is second from the left in the front row seated. Nupedia's logo. Nupedia was a web-based encyclopedia whose articles, written by volunteer contributors, possessing relevant subject matter expertise and reviewed by editors prior to publication, would be licensed as free content. It was co-founded by Jimmy Wales and underwritten by Bomis, with Sæŋər hired as editor-in-chief in February 2000. Sæŋər began to oversee Nupedia. He developed a review process for articles and recruited editors. Articles were reviewed through Nupedia's email system before being posted on the site, with Wales and Sæŋər frustrated at the slow progress of Nupedia. In January 2001, Sæŋər proposed a wiki be created to spur article development, and the result of this proposal was Wikipedia, officially launched on January 15, 2001. It was initially intended as a collaborative wiki for the public to write entries that would then be fed into the Nupedia review process of expertise, but the majority of Nupedia's experts wanted little to do with this project originally. Bomis planned to make Wikipedia profitable shortly after a blank wiki was set up. Sæŋər wrote the initial pages and promoted the site to the surprise of Sæŋər and Wales. Within a few days of launching, Wikipedia had outgrown Nupedia, and a small community of editors gathered by virtue of his position with Nupedia. Sæŋər ran the project, and formulated much of the original policy, including ignore all rules, neutral point of view, and verifiability. Wikipedia quickly took off, but just months after it was launched, things started to go off the rails, Sæŋər says, and by the summer of 2001 the new online community was being overrun by what he described as trolls and anarchist types, who were opposed to the idea that anyone should have any kind of authority that others do not. Sæŋər responded by proposing a stronger emphasis for expert editors, individuals with the authority to resolve disputes and enforce the rules. Tired of endless content battles and feeling he had a lack of support from Wales, Sæŋər eventually left the project. Sæŋər was the only paid editor of Wikipedia, a status he held from January 15, 2001, until March 1, 2002. In early 2002, Bomis announced plans to sell advertising on Wikipedia in part to pay for Sanger's job, but the project was against any commercialization. Sæŋər worked on and promoted both the Nupedia and Wikipedia projects until Bomis discontinued funding for his position in February 2002 after the collapse in internet advertising spending. Sæŋər resigned as editor-in-chief of Nupedia and as chief organizer of Wikipedia on March 1. Sæŋər's stated reason for ending his participation in Wikipedia and Nupedia as a volunteer was that he could not do justice to the task as a part-time volunteer. Nupedia shut down in 2003, shortly after Wikipedia's second anniversary. Origins of Wikipedia. A screenshot of Wikipedia's main page on September 28, 2002. Wales started to play down Sanger's role in the founding of the project in 2005, a few years after Sæŋər left Wikipedia. In light of Wales's view, Sæŋər posted on his personal webpage several links which supported his role as a co-founder. Sæŋər was identified as a co-founder of Wikipedia at least as early as September 2001. Wales identified himself in August 2002 as co-founder of Wikipedia. Sæŋər said, "While I was organizing Wikipedia, Wales was in the background and focused on Bomiscom." Wales stated in 2005 that he had initially heard of the wiki concept in 2001 not from Sæŋər, but instead from Jeremy Rosenfeld. Wales stated in October 2001 that it was Larry Gary who had the idea to use wiki software for a separate project. The critical concept of marrying the three fundamental elements of Wikipedia, namely an encyclopedia, a wiki, and essentially unrestricted editorial access to the public, first took form when sæŋər met up with an old friend, Ben Kovitz. This meeting occurred at a dinner on January 2, 2001, and it was here that sæŋər was first introduced to the functionality of wiki software. Kovitz was a computer programmer and a regular on Ward Cunningham's wiki. Sæŋər thought a wiki would be a good platform to use and decided to present the idea to Jimmy Wales. At that time, the head of BOMAS sæŋər initially proposed the wiki concept to Wales and suggested it be applied to Nupedia, and, after some initial skepticism, Wales agreed to try it. It was Jimmy Wales, along with other people, who came up with the broader idea of an open-source, collaborative encyclopedia that would accept contributions from ordinary people. And it was Wales who invested in it. Sæŋər came up with the name Wikipedia, which he later said was a silly name for what was at first a very silly project. Sæŋər first conceived of the wiki-based encyclopedia project only as a means to hopefully accelerate Nupedia's slow growth during Wikipedia's critical first year of growth. Sæŋər spearheaded and guided the following that gathered around this nucleus through this early period. He served as Wikipedia's chief organizer, a position which has not been filled since his departure from Wikipedia. Sæŋər is also credited with creating and enforcing many of the policies and strategy that made Wikipedia possible during its first formative year. By the end of the year in 2001, the site had about 15,000 articles and upwards of 350 Wikipedians post Wikipedia. Since Sæŋər parted ways with Wikipedia in 2002, he has been critical of its accuracy. Among other things, in December 2004, Sæŋər wrote a critical article for the website Kuro5 Hin, in which he stated that Wikipedia is not perceived as credible among librarians, teachers, and academics when it does not have a formal review process and it is anti-elitist. In September 2009, Sæŋər mentioned one reason for distancing himself from Wikipedia: "I thought that the project would never have the amount of credibility it could have if it were not somehow more open and welcoming to experts." He pointed out the other problem was the community had essentially been taken over by trolls to a great extent. That was a real problem, and Jimmy Wales absolutely refused to do anything about it. Wales responded by stating, "I think very highly of Larry Sæŋər, and think that it is unfortunate that this silly debate has tended to overshadow his work." Sæŋər, a philosophy instructor, began work as a lecturer at The Ohio State University, where he taught philosophy until June 2005. His professional interests are epistemology, in particular, early modern philosophy, and ethics. In December 2005, Digital Universe Foundation announced that Sæŋər had been hired as director of distributed content programs. He would be a key organizer of the Digital Universe Encyclopedia web projects, which was launched in early 2006. The Digital Universe Encyclopedia has recruited recognized experts to write articles, and to check user-submitted articles for accuracy. The first step in this effort was the expert-authored and edited Encyclopedia of Earth, an electronic reference about the Earth. The question of accuracy over Wikipedia article content spurred Sæŋər to unveil plans for a new encyclopedia called Citizendium, short for Citizens Compendium. At the Wizards of OS conference in September 2006, Sæŋər announced Citizendium as a fork of Wikipedia. The objectives of the fork were to address various perceived flaws in the Wikipedia system. The main differences would be no anonymous editing. Every author, editor would have to be identified by his, her real name, no top-down hierarchy of editors. It would aspire to be a real encyclopedia. In 2015, Sæŋər was interviewed by Zach Schwartz in Vice. In the interview, he said, among other things, that "I think Wikipedia never solved the problem of how to organize itself in a way that didn't lead to mob rule, and that since he left the project, people that I would say are trolls sort of took over. The inmates started running the asylum." Citizendium main article, Citizendium: a screenshot of Citizendium's homepage on the 2nd of January 2010. On March 25, 2007, Citizendium officially launched in early 2007. Sæŋər announced he would not head Citizendium indefinitely. 2 weeks after the launch of Citizendium, Sæŋər criticized Wikipedia, stating the latter was broken beyond repair, and had a range of problems, from serious management problems, to an often dysfunctional community, to frequently unreliable content, and to a whole series of scandals. Citizendium was an effort by Sæŋər to establish a scholarly and credible online encyclopedia which aimed to bring more accountability and academic quality to articles. Ars Technica reporter Timothy B. Lee said in 2011 that Citizendium was dead in the water. Lee noted that Citizendium's late start was a disadvantage, and that Citizendium's Growth was also hindered by an unwieldy editing model. In 2014, the number of Citizendium contributors was fewer than 100, and the number of edits per day was about a dozen or so. According to Winthrop University's Dean of Library Services, Citizendium has about 17,000 articles, of which 160 have been expert-reviewed as of August 2016. Citizendium is wiki-based, but with a few differences from Wikipedia. Prospective contributors on Citizendium were required to sign in using real names, in contrast to Wikipedia users who may remain anonymous. The site attempted to implement an expert review process, and experts tried to reach a decision for disputes that cannot be resolved by consensus after a burst of initial work. However, the site went into decline, and most of the experts left post-Citizendium in early 2009. Sæŋər effectively ceased to edit Citizendium, although an announcement confirming this was not made until July 30, 2009. On the Citizendium L mailing list on September 22, 2010, Sæŋær stepped down as editor-in-chief of Citizendium, but said, at the time, that he would continue to support the project. In April 2010, Sæŋær sent a letter to the FBI detailing his concern that Wikimedia Commons was hosting child pornography in its pedophilia and lolicon categories, later clarified as obscene visual representations of the abuse of children. Sæŋær said that he felt it was his civic duty to report the images. Sæŋær told Fox Newscom that, in 2012, he worked with Netspark to get them to donate or heavily discount its pornographic image filtering technology for use by Wikipedia. Netspark attempted to contact the Wikimedia Foundation in July-August 2012, but received no response at that time. In December 2010, commenting in regard to WikiLeaks, Sæŋær said, "I consider you enemies of the U.S., not just the government, but the people." He has worked at the WatchNLearn Project, a non-profit organization which focuses on educating young children using educational videos and other media on the web. Sæŋær was the executive director of the system. It is a non-profit funded by grants, philanthropists, and the Community Foundation of Northwest Mississippi. Sæŋær headed the development of WatchNLearn from 2008 to 2010. It consists of a repository of educational videos for kindergarten to the 12th grade. In February 2013, it ranked as the number one search result among educational videos on Google's search engine, with page views surmounting 6 million each month in 2010 and 2011. He continued working on developing a web-based reading tutorial application for beginning readers, which was launched as Reading Bear in 2012. It uses the principles of phonics, using multimedia presentations such as videos, PowerPoint presentations, and ebooks, in addition to aiming to teach children to pronounce words. It aims to teach the meaning and context of each word. In February 2013, Sæŋær announced a project he named Infobit, a crowdsourced news portal on Twitter. He wrote, "My new project will show the world how to crowdsource high-quality content, a problem I've long wanted to solve, not a wiki." The site, which sought to be a crowdsourced news aggregator, went online in December 2014. In July 2015, Sæŋær announced that the project had run out of money, he had let the programmers go, he was himself looking for a job, and that it was impossible to do a full launch of the project as the code behind it was still only capable of working at a small scale. The site no longer exists. Citation needed. Personal life. Sæŋær moved to San Diego, California, in February 2000 when he was first hired by Wales to develop Nupedia. He was married in Las Vegas, Nevada, in December 2001. In January 2002, he returned to Columbus, Ohio, where he currently resides with his wife and two children. Sæŋær supports the concept of baby reading. He says that he started teaching his boy to read before age 2, and he posted videos his child reading. Selected writings. A partial list of academic work, essays, and presentations Sæŋær has written. Academic work: Epistemic Circularity, an essay on the problem of meta-justification. How to Think About Strong Collaboration Among Professionals. Keynote at the Handelsblatt IT Congress, Bonn, Germany, January 30, 2007. Why Make Room for Experts in Web 20. Opening keynote at the SV Forum, The Business of New Media, Santa Clara, California, October 25, 2006. References. Carrot: Western History for Kids, Part 1, Ancient and Medieval, Sæŋær Academy on YouTube. Video taken from Sanger's official educational YouTube channel. Pronunciation confirmed around 0:10, accessed May 7, 2016. Carrot AB Jennifer Jolene Anderson, 2011. Wikipedia, the company and its founders. 1. Ed Abdo Group P. Carrot ABCDEFG Roush, Wade. January 2005. Larry Sæŋær's Knowledge Free for All. Technology Review, retrieved 25 March 2007. Nupedia career, 1992-1996, 1997-1998 graduate teaching associate, OSU, 2000-2002 editor-in-chief, Nupedia, co-founder and chief organizer, Wikipedia. Facilitate discussion of the project. Retrieved the 22nd of October 2013. Hometown kid and internet revolutionary. Anchorage Daily News retrieved the 25th of March 2007. Carrot Williams, Sam, April 27, 2004. Everyone is an editor. Salon Media Group P. Carrot Turtaman, Daniel, December 21, 2005. Wikipedia founder modifies his bio. CNET retrieved the 26th of March 2014. Are intimidated and bored. Sorry, Nupedia, with the tedium of the process. Press, Hot Press, April 24, 2009. Retrieved the 25th of May 2009. The 25th of March 2007. The 25th of March 2007. Citizendium, Building a Better Wikipedia, Ars Technica retrieved the 25th of March 2007. Rival makes its debut, ZDNet archived from the original on July 12, 2007 retrieved the 4th of October 2007. Allegations, co-founder grassed the outfit to the FBI. The Inquirer retrieved the 9th of October 2010. Carrot Lee Long, Robert, February 16, 2013. Watchnullernorg No. 1. DeSoto Times Tribune retrieved the 9th of November 2013. Larry Sæŋər on Facebook, Larry Sanger's channel on YouTube, Larry Sæŋər. Criticism, deletionism and inclusionism, gender bias, racial bias, media, wiki, notability, reliability, vandalism, community administrators, arbitration committee, edit a thon, list of Wikipedias, the signpost, Wikipedian in residence, Wikimania people, Florence DeVuard, Sue Gardner, James Heilman, Catherine Marr, Magnus Mansky, Eric Mahler, Larry Sæŋər, Lila Tretikov, Jimmy Wales, Wikipedians, Wikipedian of the Year, History, Bomas, Logo Controversies, U.S. Congressional Staff Edits, SJ Controversy, Siegenthaler Biography Incident, Henrik Battuta Hoax. Internet Watch Foundation, Scientology, Italian Wikipedia, Blackout English Wikipedia, Blackout Hillsborough Wikipedia Posts, MyWikibees, LSJ Bot, Visual Editor Art, Feminism No. 1, Lib 1, Ref Recognition and Honors 2008, Quadriga Award, Wikipedia Monument 2015, Erasmus Prize 2015, Princess of Asturias Award, Magna Carta and Embroidery References. An analysis, cultural bibliography, films, academic studies, Wikiscanner, Wikipedia Review, Wikipediocracy, Wiki Watch, mobile access apps, QRpedia, Wikipedia, Wikinodes, Wikipedia Zero, Wikiwin, Content Use Books LLC, DBpedia, Deletionpedia, Kiwi, Wikireader, Health Information, Similar Projects, Interpedia, Nupedia, Citizendium, Encyclopedia Libre Universal and Español, Veropedia, List of Online Encyclopedias, List of Wikis Related, Wikimedia Movement, Wikimedia Foundation Projects, Print Wikipedia. The Iraq War, A Historiography of Wikipedia, Changelogs Category.